Loving yourself is one of the most important lessons required for spiritual growth. You ask, when you say loving yourself, who is loving who? The various components of self is loving the other components of self. The mind in particular, or the Manomay Sharir, is loving the surrounding sharirs. The surrounding sharirs being the pranamay and the annamay sharir above it. And in the process, it develops the knowledge to enrich its gyanmay sharir. At that time, the only thing left is waiting for the karma bandhans to slowly burn off and eventually hitting the escape velocity, like a rocket leaves the earth at 11.2 kilometers per second, the Atman will leave the loka of Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam, or the Nashwar Loks, to go to the loka of Vaikunth, where there is no need for a trace or return, unless it wants to establish dharma and help out other poor souls who are struggling to attain nirvana. Who is loving who? The Manomay Sharir, or the mind, is learning to love its neighbors. The neighbors, as we know, Indriyani Paranunde Paramana, Manasastu Parabuddheyo, Buddhe Partastusa. The four strata that exist in our self are the I am the senses, lowest level, above which is I am the mind, above which I am the buddhi, and above which I am the soul. So the I am the mind, or the second level, is trying to love the level beneath it, I am the senses, and I am the buddhi. But the moment I say I, there is an identification, and hence the ego, risk of inflating the ego exists. We have to understand that ego, while can be harmful and disruptive in the development of the Atman in its search for Shiv Shakti, or I should say Paramatman, and eventually merging into the Parampurush or Shiva, it can devolve if there's too much identification, which will be in the realm of tamasic growth, and hence make it oblivious to its real identity, which is the sa, or the soul. So loving yourself involves encouraging yourself every day, and in the moment of Brahma Muhurat, thinking about, reflecting about your past activities for the last 24 hours, if you do dhyan once a day, or last 12 hours, if you do dhyan twice a day, morning and evening. Anyways, this is more like generating a report card in which you are evaluating your activities, and have there been activities which are purposeful, spiritually elevating. Things such as panch pratyahar, and things such as bhakti, karma and dhyan yoga. If you have some elements incorporating the panch pratyahara of the five elements and the three yoga of the bhakti, karma and dhyan yoga, then your report card gets a check mark. You are moving in the right direction. You should keep doing what you're doing. So support, encourage and give few compliments to yourself, because the compliments are going to augment the ability of the mind to not get distracted by the guneshus, the indriyartheshus, objects of sensual gratification, the patterned tracks of the three modes of material nature, to help us go beyond it in the gunatit state. So the mind is loving the senses and the thoughts, emotions, desires it is generating in its core, and the ego and the buddhi, thereby bringing them all in straight line to work with one another rather than working against one another. Working against one another is the overwhelming power given to the senses or the indriya to acquire the priya pleasures or the brief dopaminergic surges through the contact of the senses with the objects of sensual gratification. Hence, there is a compulsive craving that comes with repeated enjoyment. Dhyayato vishyan punsa sangeshte shubjayate. The important word is punsa, or repeatedly. Thinking repeatedly leads to attachment. Contacts repeatedly of the objects with the objects of sensual gratification, the tongue with the sweet, the eyes with the visual pictures that we are used to seeing, leads to sangha or attachment, and that sprouts in the mind or the manomaya sharira. It starts with the indriyas and affects the mind. So our small daily activities are slowly having accretion or deposition in the manomaya sharira, and they are changing the structure of our, or I should say content of our thoughts, emotions, desires, all of which lie in the manomaya sharira. When your thoughts, emotions and desires are aligned, and that is to say you generate only few thoughts, you get only few reactionary bounce back emotions, then your desires are more in the realm of sattva and gunatit, which are in the realm of intention, sankalp and shraddha, faith, that you will attain your goal. This is divine optimism, to be believing that the chitta has to be awakened and go back to its big daddy or Shiva. And that path is attained through Panch Pratyahara and Triyog. So loving yourself entails encouraging, first evaluating your scorecard for the last 24 hours every day in Brahma Muhurat, and then looking what areas you did well to compliment yourself, that we will keep doing this Dhyan Yoga, listening to the chanting or intermittent fasting, drinking alkaline water, all those activities. And then looking for areas of improvement. Can I do a little better? Can I stretch this beyond? So the gradual perseverance and the gradual incremental approach is going to enhance our abilities to grow our spiritual practices, to be attaining the union of the Atman with the Shiv Chitta or Paramatman. So encourage, compliment, support yourself. And second, become a critique. Because the mind can also be a critique to help it understand what it has done wrong. At any point, do not be hard on yourself. This is the worst thing that can we do to make our spiritual growth go wrong. Even if you are making mistakes, even if you are unhappy with your progress, even if your performance is suboptimal, if you're not able to listen to Hanuman Chalisa for 2 or 3 minutes, if you're not able to withdraw yourself from the sensual joys of food and sex, don't be hard on yourself. Understand that this has taken many lives and this might take few more lives, but the trajectory of movement is more important than the immediate attainment. Because if it becomes immediate, it becomes preya, dopaminergic, and whatever is rising sharply, suddenly, is going to fall sharply and suddenly. Unless, of course, if it hits escape velocity, which is not going to hit most of the time. So, my friends, love yourself unconditionally, and every day in Brahma Muhurat, evaluate your progress and compliment, encourage, support yourself to continue those good habits. At the same time, be just a little critical of how I can improve my practices, mostly in the realm of Panch Pratyahara and Tri Yoga. And doing those activities, you are creating incremental progress in your spiritual path to become a better version of yourself. The iPhone 3 will eventually become iPhone 10, but it has to go through the various upgrades, the upgrades that are created by Panch Pratyahara and Tri Yoga. So don't be hard on yourself. Love, encourage yourself unconditionally. This is sattvic growth of the ego, which is totally fine, because then it creates self-confidence, self-respect, and at the highest realm, activation of Vishuddha courage, that I can attain the impossible. I can return to my blissful abode of Shiv Chit. Jai Shri Ram.